I, for one, have never really been a fan of physics. I took AP Physics in high school, and let me tell you, it was a struggle from day one. But what I've learned over the years is that physics can actually be interesting, with topics other than gravitational force and kinetic energy, of course. Physics can change the world. Now, I'm sure you're wondering why me, a 19-year-old mechanical engineering student, is here talking to you today. I might be underqualified on paper, but what I'm here to talk about does not require a degree to understand. All it requires is one severely obsessed student to explain it to you. And luckily for all of you, that's me. For some reason, it seems that Generation Z and millennials are obsessed with the idea of alternate dimensions or parallel universes. TV shows like Star Trek, cartoons like Rick and Morty, Marvel movies, all down to the run-of-the-mill teenage teen drama, have all slowly introduced these theories into the mainstream. Now, they're usually written off as fiction or fantasy, but there is a scientific basis to these types of stories. Maybe you're familiar with something called the Mandela effect. It's the idea behind what is a bunch of people from different countries and continents all remembering an event in history happening in a specifically certain way. However, when we look back into history and look at our documentation of said event, it seems to have happened in a completely different manner. For example, the Berenstain Bears, a popular kids' TV show and book series from the 80s. Now, most of the world recalls the spelling being the Berenstain Bears. Heck, even I recall that spelling. But when we look at every TV show aired and every book published, it seems to have always been the Berenstain Bears. Now, I would leave it up to a faulty memory, but most of the world agrees with me on this. So how can all of these people who have never met and have never connected before remember a false memory like this? Simple. Alternate dimensions. At least, that's the consensus on Twitter. And you know what? There may be some truth to that theory. I mean, it's not that simple, but there are many things that suggest that alternate dimensions may exist. So there's plenty of theories created to explain these types of things, but the one I'm going to talk to you today about is the fourth dimension. How we can understand, visualize, and comprehend the fourth dimension, and why it's so difficult to do something like this. And hopefully after, you'll be able to explain the fourth dimension in a way that your little cousin and your grandma can all comprehend. So many of these TV shows and pop culture influences may depict dimensions as some faraway place you can visit with a spaceship. But to physicists and mathematicians, a dimension is really just a direction. So the first step in understanding dimensions is starting with our own. So as you know, we are 3D objects, meaning we have three dimensions or three directions. Height being the very important third dimension, alongside length, and width being the first and second. So as you can see, they're all perpendicular to each other. So I guess if we wanted to have a fourth dimension, it would have to be perpendicular to the last three. But we don't have another direction or way to go to create this fourth axis. So how can the fourth dimension exist? Some people may be thinking, well, isn't time the fourth dimension? I mean, Einstein said so. And you know what? That's not a false statement. We can think of time like a spatial dimension. So in the first, second, and third spatial dimensions, you can tell one point in space from another and move forwards and backwards. And you can do the same thing with time, right? You can tell one point in time from another and move forwards, but not backwards. So time doesn't really work out to be like the other spatial dimensions. So it's not wrong to think of time like this. Rather, it's wrong to assume that time and spatial dimensions are the same thing. Now, this may be a little complex to understand, so we're going to leave our 3D world and go to the fascinating world of Super Mario. Have you ever seen an old-fashioned Mario game? His head is perpetually facing the right as he walks along the screen. Now, have you ever thought about what Mario sees? Well, he's a two-dimensional character in a two-dimensional world on a two-dimensional screen. So if we were to flip the screen so that we can see Mario's perspective, we would realize the only thing that exists are one-dimensional lines. These lines grow in size as objects get closer to him and shrink as they move farther away. So what does this mean? Well, this means that Mario cannot fully understand his two-dimensional existence. Even if he looked in the mirror, he would only see himself portrayed as a colorful one-dimensional line. So for us as humans, if Mario lives in 2D in season one, and we live in 3D, then that must mean that we see in 2D. Many may just assume that, yeah, we're three-dimensional, so we see in 3D, but that's not necessarily true. Picture this. You're sitting in a train and you're looking outside the window. As you're looking outside the window, you fall asleep. And while you're sleeping, somebody replaces your window with a screen showing the exact same thing. Now, when you wake up, you would not be able to tell the difference. This basically goes to show that we really only see and comprehend two dimensions. Yes, we know of the third dimension and can tell when there's height or depth, but actually being able to see that depth is not in our capabilities with our 2D understanding. So that would conclude that we as humans cannot fully understand our own three-dimensional existence like Mario couldn't. Take a look at this block. We're all aware that this is in fact a cube, despite that from where I'm looking, all I see is a square. But when I turn it, I'll be able to see the other sides and essentially prove to myself that this is in fact a cube. Even you at home may only be seeing a square, yet somehow you know that this is a cube. This further proves that, yes, we know of the third dimension, but actually being able to see it is not in our capabilities. So if we as humans are able to fully understand Mario's length and width, yet he's only able to understand the length, then that could conclude that there's some four-dimensional creature that's able to understand our length, width, and height. That would mean that they can see the front, back, inside, and outside of 3D objects simultaneously. I mean, we have no idea what this would even look like. I guess we can picture a see-through object, perhaps, but even still, parts of your vision are blocked. Like this glass. I can see to the other side of the glass, but I'm not actually seeing the other side. In fact, it's impossible in our world to do so. Another way to think of dimensions is through shadows and projections. So, as you can see, the shadow of 3D objects are 2D objects or 2D projections. So, that would imply that the shadow of four-dimensional objects would be entire 3D objects or 3D projections. So, take a square. A square is two-dimensional. If we expand that square along the third dimension, we get a cube. Expand that cube along the fourth dimension, and we get something called a tesseract, or a hypercube. Now, if you saw Avengers, you may be familiar with the term tesseract, but no, not that type of tesseract. A tesseract is a four-dimensional object that, because it's four-dimensional, we're not able to visualize it, but we can see its three-dimensional projection. Now, the image of its projection may be a little confusing to look at first glance, so we're going to break it down for a second. Take a look at this hollowed cube. As you can see, the shadow on the wall changes as the cube rotates. The biggest square on the wall is the face closest, and the smallest square on the wall is the face furthest. As it rotates, the squares trade places. The biggest square becomes the smallest, and the smallest square becomes the biggest. Now, the same thing in the fourth dimension. If we were to rotate a four-dimensional tesseract in 4D space in a similar fashion to the cube, it would look something like this. Notice how the entire cubes get bigger and smaller in of themselves, just how the squares did. I mean, this is fascinating geometry. Think about all the other shapes that can be created through four-dimensional analysis. Four-dimensional objects move in ways that are unheard of. I mean, they morph in size and shape and disappear and reappear in ways we've never seen. So if we can think of Mario one more time, this is the last time, I promise. So Mario can actually see multi-dimension objects. I mean, if a two-dimensional square was to intersect Mario's two-dimensional plane, it would be seen to Mario in his one-dimensional understanding and look like a line. Now, if it was slightly to the left or to the right of Mario's plane, he would not be able to see it at all. He's only able to see it as it intersects as a one-dimensional cross-sectional line. So I guess we can say the same thing for the fourth dimension. If a four-dimensional cube or hypercube was to intersect our three-dimensional plane, it would look exactly the same as a regular 3D object. Now, if a cube was to intersect Mario's two-dimensional plane, it would look exactly the same as the square did and be seen in his one-dimensional understanding and look like a line. Now, Mario might be scared or confused, being that this object keeps disappearing and reappearing in ways that he's never seen before. In the past, lines have only gotten longer and shorter, depending on if objects have gotten closer and farther away from him. So what does this mean? This means that all objects can be seen from all planes, but in different forms. So if a four-dimensional hypercube intersected our three-dimensional plane, it would look exactly the same as a regular 3D object, but it would move in ways that we've never seen before, disappearing and reappearing, morphing in size and shape. So if we can look at this cube and see that it can enter multiple 2D planes at the same time, then the same thing can be said for the hypercube. The hypercube can enter multiple 3D planes simultaneously. So if we can think of 2D planes like pieces of paper stacked up against each other in the third direction of height to create our three-dimensional space, then there should exist some fourth dimension that allows 3D space to be stacked into to create it. This fourth dimension or fourth direction that 3D space can be stacked into would create what is known as four-dimensional space. Now, when we think of stacking 3D spaces, we know we just get a larger 3D space. And when Mario thinks about expanding his worlds, he can only imagine a bigger computer screen. So we have no idea, once again, what four-dimensional space would look like. So there should be some next direction that allows 3D space to be stacked into to create four-dimensional space. Now, this theory would imply that there can be multiple 3D worlds that coexist without interdimensional interaction. This would mean that there can be multiple 3D universes that exist in our one universe. This is the basis of parallel universes. Multiple 3D worlds coexisting, possibly being copies of each other with different histories. Now, the fourth dimension can explain some of the most perplexing things in the world. I mean, people who have claimed to see ghosts or extraterrestrial creatures claim that one second they were there, and the next day we're gone, disappearing and reappearing almost instantaneously. Now, what if it was just a four-dimensional creature intersecting our 3D plane for a brief moment before moving on to the next? I mean, it sounds crazy, but if you think about it, we do it all the time. Anytime we move through space, we're just moving through an infinitesimal amount of 2D planes stacked in our third direction of height to create our dimension. Now, not to get too sciencey, but string theory, aka the theory of everything, which basically explains the fundamentals of our universe, like gravity, predicts that there are 10 spatial dimensions. I mean, surely the fourth dimension is stacked in some fifth direction to create a fifth dimension, and so on. I mean, the possibilities are endless. In addition, scientists have found this force called dark energy. It's constant everywhere in time and space, which doesn't make sense in our 3D world. One way to support higher dimension theories is through finding the source of forces like this. If there's a force acting between these unseen parallel universes, it could be explained through dark energy. So I hope by now you have a better understanding of the fourth dimension. I hope to have expanded your mind outside of our confined 3D space. While string theory and dark energy could be TED Talks on their own, I encourage you to explore these topics on your free time. These were not the things I was learning while in my AP Physics class, but I think equally as important and definitely more intriguing. And the best part is, it doesn't require a degree to understand. All it requires is one severely obsessed student to explain it to you. And now, that can be you.